black. Still have my bottle black here. So first of all, step one in doing these, of course, is to make sure that they stand well. I do move around a tiny bit in the bisque, so I have to check that before I do. Dog clippers. Dog nail clippers are the wondrous item for trimming horses. So I do that, make sure it's nice and balanced, since it's really solid, as you can see. So I'll clip it and then give it a little shave down so it's got a nice smooth bottom there. Okay. And then go over the figure and make sure there's not anything too egregious. And the whole point of these sculptures is that they're very spontaneous. So, you know, they don't have to be super clean, but to be distracting and that there's a piece of porcelain sticking off where it shouldn't be sticking off. So there you go. So get back to the paint. And basically what I'm going to do is load the points with color so I can use that on the body and spread it around. So I'm going to heavily paint the socks dark down here. And then the end of the tail. Something I like to make sure that I do is, as I'm painting here, you'll see what happens is that I want to keep it kind of, I want a nice little blaze on the head, so I'm just going to be careful where I carry the paint with my watery brush. So I'm just going to pull the color off the socks here and just keep pounding on the water. And this ends up, you can kind of see the paint strokes, and because of the way I sculpt, as I'm pulling that, you're going to start seeing the details of the stretch and pull of the clay starting to show up, because the black will go down into those cracks, so it kind of accentuates that this is a piece made of clay, not a mold or anything else, so I kind of like doing the black washes like this. Color. And then I'm just going to quickly do the head. I've got a good color on there. And then pull it down. Okay. And then do a little nose and eye. Looks like it's mainly a good color there, so just a little forelock there. And so that's the gray so far. And then gonna spot in some spots. There you go. That's done. Okay, I'm gonna do an Appaloosa. Appaloosas are incredibly popular, so I normally just love that type of horse. I love Appaloosas, but I'm glad everybody else seems to like them too. Okay. So again, we're going to load dark. Some of them do a pretty dark Appaloosa, so I'll just put that dark on here. And a little darker, so let's go here. Here. Nice thing about this is I don't have to dot the eyes because, you know, it's dark there. I'm thinking about a little star blaze, so I'm just going to carefully go in there and just here. And one of the reasons I love underglaze is that it's very controlled. So, you know, if I put my black underglaze here on this piece, it's going to stay where I put it. So I don't have to think about, oh, it's going to run. On larger pieces, of course, I like my glaze to be runny because, you know, I get more excitement and stuff in the color. And something happened with this piece that happens occasionally. This is a reject now. Then we're going to start over. He snapped his leg. I wasn't being very careful anyway. So this is a tripod. Clip his little leg again. And more. Now, there's only so far that I can clip these and still look reasonably still look good. Yeah, he's not bleeding. Looks nice. Break in firing. I've had very thin limbs like that fail because they're supporting structures and it's melting. So back to the Abbey painting. Looks like this one's gonna get a narrow blaze. Lots of black loaded on the piece now, so now I'm just going to use all that black to kind of shove down towards the rear end where the blanket is going to be. Actually spotted and solid, and you can kind of faintly see it, so I'll spot over the gray areas too. And there's the Appaloosa.